Hello, Dr. Joe here of the 2020forum.com. Now, if you remember in my last video, I talked about the signs and symptoms of chronic kidney disease. And in that video, I gave you 11 signs and symptoms. And I talked about the fact that the more symptoms you have on that list, the higher the likelihood that you've got a problem. In particular, if you had symptom number 8 and symptom number 11. Now, also, if you remember, I repeatedly talked about getting screened in that video. And the idea behind getting screened is that you either establish that you've got a problem or exclude it. Now, how do you get screened? Well, you get tested. So in this video, we're going to be talking about the tests that we do to either establish or exclude chronic kidney disease. Because our chronic kidney disease has implications for high blood pressure. So you need to know this. So what are the tests that are required? Well, there are four tests that we normally do. Tests number 1 and 2 are very commonly done. Tests number 3 and 4 are sometimes done. It depends on how badly we want to chase the problem down the rabbit hole. But tests number 1 and 2 are essential. So what are these tests? So let's get started. So the first test is a blood test, okay? And it's called EGFR, which means estimated glomerular filtration rate. And what does EGFR do? Well, it measures the level of your kidney function, and it also determines the stage of your kidney disease. Okay, now the EGFR is calculated from the results of your blood creatinine test, your age, your body size, and your gender. All of these parameters are plugged into an algorithm, and then it spits out a result for us. Okay, so that's test number one. So test number 2 is a urine test, okay? It is a urine test, and we're looking out for albumin. Albumin does not belong to your urine. If it is there, that means there is a problem. We're also looking for the amount of creatinine in there, and the albumin and the creatinine, they are computed into a figure which gives us an albumin creatinine ratio, also called ACR. Okay, so that's test number 2. Now, test number 3 are imaging tests, okay? These are imaging tests, and by that, I'm referring to ultrasound scan, which is the basic scanning of your kidneys. We also can do CT scan or MRI scan. It depends on, you know, how much you want to investigate. And what are these tests looking for? Well, we're looking for the size and structure of your kidneys, and we also want to exclude any kidney blockages as well. Okay, so those are the tests that constitute imaging tests. So that's test number 3. So test number 4 is kidney biopsy. Okay, when we get to this stage, then you know that the problem is really very bad and we really want to find out what's going on. So the kidney biopsy is done. This is a situation where we set a very fine needle through the skin into the kidney, take a little piece of tissue, and then it's examined under the microscope. We're looking for the cause of your failing kidneys, and we're also looking for the extent of kidney damage, okay? So that's test number 4. So now, the other thing I want to do is talk about the interpretation of test number 1 and 2, because these are the tests that are commonly done, and the reason I want to talk about this is, if your doctor is delivering the results to you, they will make more sense to you having watched this video. Now, remember, the EGFR is a blood test. That's the most commonly done test. Now, what I want you to imagine is, see your kidney function, put it on a scale of 0 to 100. 100 being the best and 0 being the worst, okay? That's the way I want you to imagine your EGFR, to put it into perspective. So the EGFR test is given in stages, okay, stages 1 to 5. And so stage 1, you have an EGFR of more than 90 mils per minute. So that's more than 90%. That's why I want you to think about it. It's more than 90% function. So your kidneys are still firing well, okay? So that's stage 1. What does it mean? Well, stage 1 means that you got some kidney damage, but your kidney function is still intact. So you still got normal kidney function. All right, so that's good. That's not bad at all, stage 1, CKD. So that's stage 1. So stage 2 refers to EGFR of between 60 to 89 mils per minute. So see it as between 60 to 89%, okay, functionality. And what does it mean? It means that there's been some kidney damage with mild loss of kidney function. So there's been some damage, but you know, you just got mild loss of function. And a lot of people will fall into this category, actually, especially if you've got long-standing high blood pressure. So that's stage two. Now, let's talk about EGFR stage three. Now, stage three is split into two. So EGFR of between 45 to 59 mils per minute. So see that as between 45 to 59%. What it means is you've got mild to moderate loss of kidney function, okay? And then stage 3B is EGFR of between 30 to 44 mils per minute. And that means you've got moderate to severe loss of kidney function. That's stage three, okay? So you've got 3A and 3B. So what about stage four? Well, stage four is EGFR of between 15 to 29 mils per minute, which means severe loss of kidney function. You really don't want to get to stage four if you can help it. Okay, so that's stage four. So what about stage five? Stage five, all right, remember I said see your kidney function, your EGFR as a percentage. So what stage five means is EGFR of below 15 mils per minute. So that's your kidney is functioning below 15% of its normal capacity. You know, that's really bad when you get to stage five. And that means true kidney failure. Okay, so that's stage five. So that's the blood test, EGFR. What about the urine test? Now, this is given as albumin creatinine ratio from stage one to three. So A1, which is stage one of the urine result, it means albumin creatinine ratio of less than 3 milligram per millimole or less than 30 milligram per gram. I put these two units there because different hospitals use different units or different countries use different units. So you have an option here to choose which one your clinic is using or your hospital is using. Okay, so that's stage A1. And stage A2 means you've got albumin creatinine ratio of between 3 to 29 milligram per millimole or 30 to 299 milligram per gram. Okay, and stage A3 means albumin creatinine ratio of more than 30 milligram per millimole or more than 300 milligram per gram, depending on what unit your hospital or clinic is using. So these are the blood and urine test results and how to interpret them. Now, when you get into A3, stage A3 of the albumin creatinine ratio, then things are really very bad. It means you're pushing out a lot of proteins in your urine, and you know that severe leakage simply means your kidneys are really beginning to fail. And if you've got that, that usually ties with, you know, chronic kidney disease stages 4 and 5. So when you've got that, you know you've got a serious problem. Indeed, when you've got CKD stage 5, your only help is usually dialysis and looking for a donor. Okay, a kidney donor. So these are the stages of chronic kidney disease and the tests that need to be done. So hopefully you got some value from this. And the idea behind this video is for you to know that you've got a problem when you're tested, and also you know, to know what to do next. Because what we want to do is to halt the progression. Wherever stage you are in, we need to halt the progression of the disease. So because you don't want things to progress beyond where they are. Can you improve it? Well, sometimes it's possible. And I'm going to be talking about some of the things that you can do to either halt the progression of chronic kidney disease or to even improve it in some of the future videos. So if you got some value from this video, as usual, please give it a thumbs up, please like the video. If you got any comments, leave them down below, as usual. Please share this video with your friends, family, and colleagues. I think that's about it. Please do join us at the 2020forum.com. There should be two videos on your screen now. Please click to watch any of the two videos. They are videos that are designed to enable you to take control of your health. That's it. Until next time, well, this is Dr. Joe signing out.